At this point, let's cross yet another line. Communism. Just follow me on this analogy. If socialism is Grendel, then communism would be Grendel's mom. But Grendel's mom, as much as she may send red-blooded Americans running to the hills, is alive here in the United States. RT correspondent Priya Sridhar revisits this story.
There you go.
Keenan and Rowan Dakota seem like a typical father and son, working together to rebuild a barn. But their lives are far from ordinary. They live at Twin Oaks, a commune spread over 500 acres in rural Virginia that promotes self-sufficiency and egalitarianism.
In the mainstream society, there's a class system, and we do everything in our policies and in our culture to have a classless society. So it's important that we all live here equally.
And 13-year-old Rowan has spent his entire life right here with the 100 people who have decided to make Twin Oaks their home.
I like the people here. Like, they're all very nice people.
The community has an organized labor system where residents maintain a 42-hour work quota each week. That quota can be met by putting in hours caring for children, making furniture, milking cows, and more.
There's hardly any other communism in the world. Like, globally, communism has collapsed. The few communist places there are left are Twin Oaks and Cuba.
But in this communist society, if you don't pull your weight, you can be exiled back to capitalist America to fend for yourself.
And we have a pretty strong commitment to working and making the place work. And if there's somebody who sort of consistently doesn't pull their weight, we have a single sanction, which is, psh, you're out of here.
But as more Americans are losing their job in the real world, places like Twin Oaks are becoming more popular. Right now, Twin Oaks residence halls are full, and there's even a waiting list to get in.
With the recession, this has become much more popular, this type of living situation, and that could be part of it. Over the last decade or two, I think real income has been dropping, and you know, it's been harder for middle-class people.
Even though this community is primarily self-sufficient, they do have this hammock business. The money they make from the hammocks, they put into a communal checkbook to pay for things like car repairs, clothes, and electric bills. It's their way of conforming capitalism to their communist lifestyle.
I think an interesting difference between communism and capitalism is that here in our communal society is that people are happier but a little less productive. Out there in the mainstream capitalist society, people are productive, but I think not as happy.
That's exactly why Keenan Dakota has decided to raise his son here, far away from mainstream America.
Basically, the things that most parents want for their kids, for them to be in a safe environment with loving people, is the things that Twin Oaks provides.
Building a future in their own little utopia. Priya Sridhar, RT, Louisa County, Virginia.
Priya Sridhar joins us now. Priya, so, I mean, when you say you're a communist to an American, and I'm sure that these people have encountered this, when they come out and say, I'm a communist, they must get some sort of weird looks from the American public. Have they said anything about that?
Yeah, absolutely. But I think these guys kind of pride themselves on thinking outside of the box and not going along with mainstream America, as you saw Keenan Dakota point out. And that's part of the reason he chose to kind of live this lifestyle, mm-hmm. because he wanted to move away from mainstream America. But, you know, I think it's a point that you guys brought up really well in the debate that you just had, mm-hmm. that, you know, there are all these kind of misconceptions when it comes to communism and socialism and all of that. And in some ways, you know, our generation and the generation before us, our parents' generation, you know, we grew up in that kind of communism is horrible, socialism is
right.
horrible. So, you know, people have been brainwashed to think that this is a type of model that could never work in the United States or it's always going to be bad. And that's why, you know, when you look at today's events with the Tea Partiers, you see them holding up a picture of Obama with a little Hitler mustache. So,
or a hammer and sickle sign just right. to kind of to drive home the point. But here's the thing, though. I mean, in the political spectrum, socialism is a little bit more center than communism.
Right.
Yet these people decided to go all the way to communism. Mm-hmm. Have they said why not? I mean, why can't they just be socialist? I mean, why do they have to go out as far as being communist?
I mean, they really believe in a classless society, and I think that's okay. kind of the fundamental value that, you know, they really don't like the fact that there are the super, super rich and the really, really poor, and they'd rather just, you know, live a kind of comfortable lifestyle. And I think, you know, you look at the economy right now, and a lot of people are getting laid off, and they're kind of, you know, they have this sort of kumbaya attitude. Why can't we all just work together and, you know, have a lifestyle where we're all comfortable. We might not have as much as we would maybe if we were not in this lifestyle, but at least we won't be struggling.
There was something that I believe Mr. Dakota said inside your story, and this is kind of an extraneous question, but it just kind of piqued my interest here. He says that if you don't really kind of follow the rules of that society of Twin Oaks, mm-hmm. that you're out of here. Where do they go? What happens to these people?
They get exiled back into mainstream America, Cedric.
Oh, no.
And that's kind of the ironic thing, because you think about communism and you think about government control and, you know, the government's controlling everything. But in this case, it's communism within the United States of America. And the reason these people are choosing to join the society is to get away from American government and to get away from the mainstream America that they believe isn't right. So it's just kind of interesting and ironic that in this situation, if you don't follow the rules, you can
Absolutely.
Get exiled out.
Because, I mean, it's such a vast departure of how we Americans were taught about communism that you're stuck inside it no matter what.
Right.
If you hate it, too bad for you. This is where you were born. Too bad you're stuck. But now you're saying you could be on your way out if you don't follow the rules, if you don't follow the quotas.
Exactly.
We actually are starting to run out of time, so thank you so much for joining us, and thank you for really just really getting to the nuts and bolts of this and looking at this issue very intricately.